In this video, you'll watch me build an AI chat agent for a client. The client is an e-bike rental business in Berlin. They want a chat feature on their website capable of answering all customer questions. For example, how much an e-bike costs, which models are available, and if there's a nearby location. They provided files containing all the necessary information. In the next few minutes, I'll demonstrate how you could handle similar situations and build the same chatbot yourself. I'll show you a straightforward method using N8N, a no-code tool that allows us to create the necessary workflows. Later, I'll demonstrate how to use it to easily populate your own vector store with the required data and build a chat that accesses this data. I'll also provide example code for accessing a provided chat endpoint to integrate the chat into your web applications. The complete process consists of three steps. Prepare the data given by the client. Build a workflow that inserts the data into a vector store. Build a chat agent that can access the vector store to instantly answer based on this data. This video will equip you with all the knowledge needed to build these types of chatbots for yourself or to offer as a service to clients. If you're considering starting your own AI side hustle, whether through AI SaaS applications or freelancing, visit aifordevs.com. Without further ado, let's dive in and build this solution together. After completing the free registration, we arrive at the main interface where we can immediately begin creating a workspace. Our initial step is to add a manual trigger. Next, we'll establish a connection to Google Drive. We search for Google Drive and click on the first result. In this step, we want to search files within the drive. We first need to establish a connection to the Google Drive API. To create this connection, we need a client ID and a client secret. We'll obtain these from the Google Cloud Console. First, ensure the Google Drive API is activated, indicated by a checkmark. If not, activate it by clicking the appropriate button. Our next step is to create the client ID and client secret. Navigate to Credentials, select Create Credentials, and choose OAuth Client ID. Select Web Application, assign a name, and input the URL from N8N. After creation, you'll receive a client ID and client secret. Enter these in N8N and save. Test the connection by clicking Sign in with Google and confirming the dialog. A successful connection will be indicated. Now let's add a filter to select only files from the Berlin Bike folder. Test this step to confirm it recognizes all relevant text files. Now that we have access to the files, we need to download them to the workspace before adding them to the vector store. For file downloading, search for Google Drive again and select Download File. Choose the credentials we just created. We'll use the ID from the current step for each file and replace the file name with the actual name. Test this step to ensure proper file downloading. And it looks good. We see that the files have been downloaded accordingly. We can now take care of the integration within Pinecone. For this, we search for Pinecone and select the Pinecone vector store. We see that an API key is needed to connect. To access our Pinecone instance, we go to the Pinecone page and create a so-called index. This corresponds to a database in a relational database. We select text embedding 3 small as the embedding. And since we want to create a free index, we use Amazon as a provider. We see that an empty index is now being created and we can use it right away. We then click on API keys and create a new API key. We copy this and can now enter it here. This worked well too. We can save the files in the new index Bike Berlin. Now we have to tell it how the embeddings should be created. And here we select the same embedding again. But in order to make it possible, we first have to connect it to OpenAI. That's why I copy my OpenAI key and now select the same embedding model again, text embedding 3 small. We now have to adjust at the vector store that we want to add data. For this, we click on Pinecone Vector Store and select Insert Documents as operation mode. When we have done that, we see a new plus symbol, and here we can then select how the data is loaded. We select binary and leave all other options exactly as before. We have to tell it how large texts should be split. And for this, we take the simplest, the token splitter, which should split the texts, all 5,000 tokens, and there should be an overlap of 1,000 tokens. Good, then we can execute it. For this, we just click on the small play button. Okay, that looks very good, and we can now look in Pinecone whether the data has been correctly entered in our index. We see several entries, and if we go to the clear text view, then we see the content of the different text files with information such as the locations or the bike types. Perfect! In the next step, we will now take care of building a chat that can respond to this data. We start here with a trigger that starts when a chat message is received, and we add an AI agent node in the next step. We choose the option Conversational Agent and give him a system message that fits his task better. We tell him, "You're a helpful AI assistant that helps Bikes Berlin to provide useful answers to customers' questions. You're humorous and you don't make things up. If you don't find the answer, ask the customer to call the hotline." Now we have to assign a language model to the agent. We use GPT-4 for this. As memory, we use a simple window buffer memory, which keeps the last 5 messages local, like a kind of short-term memory. We tell him that he can call a vector store via the vector store tool. And as a description of this tool, we say that he should call this tool if he wants to give relevant and useful answers to the customer. All right, let's tidy up a bit to keep everything organized. Now we have to select that the database under the tool is our Pinecone database. And we enter the corresponding index. Now we need to tell him which embedding was used initially. We can do this by clicking on the small plus icon labeled Embedding. And to correctly interpret the embedding, we select Text Embedding 3 small again. Then we have to determine a language model that interprets the results of Pinecone. Here we use again GPT-4o. I think our masterpiece is complete and we have a great first version. We have an agent that is triggered whenever a new message is received. The chat has short-term memory and can access a tool connected to the Pinecone database where our documents are already embedded. Now we can try out our chat. How much does an e-bike cost for 1 hour? The calculation looks good. It says that an e-bike costs 10 euros based on the data in the text document. I ask again if he has bikes near Alexanderplatz. This question is also correctly answered from the information from the text documents. Now we have a question that is a bit more complex. And he says he can't answer it, but he correctly refers to the hotline. Perfect. Now I want to show you how to install this chat on a real website with custom code. We see here that we have a chat URL that can be reached from outside. We can use this URL in our code to address the chat. I have here a small example script built, which uses this URL and a small web UI. You can find a link to the code in the description. It's a very basic JavaScript node project that gives you a starting point to integrate these chats in your websites.